Hello. Hi, I'm Patricia McNeely. I am an illumined Blu-ray twin flame from Chicago, Illinois. I hope everyone's doing well. Thank you so much for watching my videos. Thank you to everyone who has somehow participated and you've got my webinars. You're actually participating in your own union, and that's a wonderful thing. I do see and feel the progress. Now, this video is to talk about just a couple things that are right smack in this week. It is going to be the November 25th full moon, which is tomorrow. And here in the United States, a big holiday that we have called Thanksgiving. And the original intention of this is, yes, gratitude, to give thanks, to share, to show. And yet it's, you know, it's become very extreme for some people where it stresses people out. It also brings people together with their families of origin. It's also a big shopping event, which both delights some people and other people find highly offensive. So, you know, it's all across the board of emotion for a lot of people. But that's not what I want to talk to you about. Is, you know, I don't want to talk about some of that stuff. What I want to talk to you about is, you know, what are some of the things that you might feel for your union and moving along with it. All right, I did a video last year at Thanksgiving where I talked almost exclusively about gratitude. But this is a different year. The energies are different and they're significant differences between the energies last year and the energies this year. And first and foremost, there has been a separation of worlds. It started peeling away in July. It wrapped up in August. The Lion's Gate was for closing the gate. And then September, October, all of the retrogrades were for actually in the physical life reviewing things. Now, this full moon that is happening just before Thanksgiving is going to shed light and make things crystal clear, transparently clear to some of you who are very astute. If you've been working on your senses, if you've been working on your light body, and if you don't know what I'm talking about, working on your light body, check out some of my webinars because I have several exercises in there to open up the channels. When you open up, you clear out and release. And, you know, a lot of you have been doing work. You've been getting healings. You've been getting treatments. You've been taking supplements. And I applaud you. You're doing fabulous. Many of you are not missing a thing. But this is a process. I want to remind everyone that this is a process of being able to let go of things. Things aren't intended to fall apart completely. And you're not intended to have a nervous breakdown with this, and nor is your twin flame. That's important to know. The very person that you want in the entire universe, you don't want them to have a nervous breakdown and get sick with some of this stuff. Because being in 3D, being back in karma, it makes us sick. It makes angels sick. If you've been feeling the parts of you that are human angelic, and especially angelic and high-level angelic, as a twin flame and you're able to be, you will know that there's times when things do make you feel sick and how do you adjust. And I actually do cover that in some of my webinars. So, but that's not the focus here. The focus is when these things are shed light on, can you handle the truth? And there are people that will take a retreat and they'll go delve back into the boxes where they found safety, whether it's other people, a soulmate relationship, a marriage. Some of the key differences here are that you've separated from those from the old world, the old life, the karma. Karma ended, actually 2008 is when it started ending. 2010 is when we really just jumped into quantum time, and many of you are finishing up the last bits of it. Some of you are finished. You're finished and you're concluding or helping your twin to conclude the last pieces of it. And what is karma? It's quite simply a balancing, or it's dualistic, you know, this side and this side. Two sides of the coin, two sides of the fence. You're going into a much higher level. You're not just living in two dimensions or three dimensions. You're living multidimensionally. So, some of the things that are coming up here that have to do with any world events that happen. And there's a special emphasis upon children, upon the children that are being affected by many of these world events. Many of those children are our children. Some of them are your lost children. Some of them belong out of the countries that they're streaming out of, and they belong elsewhere. It's a hurt thing. There are people who don't get pregnant or can't get pregnant because the heart is staying open to receive some and absorb in some of the people, and especially the children that are here and were promised new homes. When people were incarnated, there were promises and agreements made. And these are what I would say agreements on a global scale. However, you can't just relegate it. You can't keep it behind something. You can no longer hide it. There is transparency now. And the full moon is what sheds light on things and being thankful. And, you know, this is the American Thanksgiving. But what I will say to you is at every single one of these portals, we are pulling the energetics out of people. And this then stirs things up. It will seem like some sort of a mental fog, a mental cloud. It will be sadness. It will be grieving. It will be leaving people behind. It may be a sense of liberation, freedom, breaking free of the prisons of our own making. So this moon is also in some cultures called the mourning or the grieving moon, but it is there for you to let go of the past. You're letting go of the past, and I would, for several months, I've been getting exactly this time frame, right around the November 24th to the 30th time frame for some of this stuff. And if you've noticed, what you have is that sometimes it seems like situations just stay in place, like it repeats and it repeats and it repeats until one change is made. And you're the only one that can make the change, for right or for wrong. And you have to go with what you feel is best in the situation. And even if it's wrong, you trust that you'll make it right at some point. If you're making a wrong decision, you will make it right at some point, because you're trusting your own heart. If you're being feeling misguided or without the guidance, you're doing the best you can. If you don't know what to do, you pause and breathe. Nobody needs to be Chicken Little with the sky falling on their heads right now. That is not who we are. That is not worthy of you. That is really not the magnificent being that you are. So, this morning moon, it will be very short-lived. And I can give you a personal reference here. About 2 months ago, we had a person in the family die. It was my brother's mother-in-law. And she'd been sick. She was elderly. But it happened suddenly. Her heart gave out. That was it. While I was at the funeral home, of all places, I was guided to use my body and to be the conduit right then and there. And while the person who was performing the service was droning on and on with prayers that I couldn't even hear it, because I've really left those spaces. They were things by rote that I couldn't really click with anymore. But what I did feel was an upliftment in the room. It was almost as though my body was the thing bolted to the floor to lift up the entire room. And if you could see this place, this funeral home was stuck in a time warp. The decor was circa 1965. They hadn't updated a thing. So this was also ironic that here we were uplifting it, upgrading it, and yet to look around, it was so old it was retro chic. It had actually come back into style. It was what's now called mid-century modern style. So for those of you who aren't into fashion or interior design, sorry for getting off track here, but what then occurred was what I felt, which was that this was being done so that people will be able to release their grief and their mourning easier. In other words, instead of people who would come there to grieve a dead relative, a dead child, anybody who had died, the entire place had been uplifted. And I know it's not just that place, it was probably other places, but right here in my grid, I was the conduit to uplift so that people have an easier time with their grief, and the grief goes away easier. That's just one of the ways that the love does things, by being. That's what's meant by being. When I was being my high self and allowing and bringing in the love and lifting things off of people very easily, I didn't have to touch a person. So when you do this, when you let go of the past and you get yourself through the grief and you don't know how, go back to my July webinar where I talk about holding your love bubble to have all of those low emotions just be more easily released from you. That's how. You are making fresh new love together. You always are. You always are. Because many of you are already significantly merged on other levels. And you're not giving yourself proper credit for being more than just human. You will have more transparency so that you are transcending. And you are transcending everything in your union. And the transcendence is when you go back into karmic situations, whether it is a job, a situation, a group, a family situation, Thanksgiving, or with a marriage. If it's a karmic marriage, if it is not your divine marriage and you go back in, I want you to really see how it feels. If you're in it, if you're still in it, expect transparency where you start to see things. Because this Thanksgiving, and again, I encourage you, if you've usually had a few drinks to cope with your family, why don't you try abstaining and really see with fresh eyes what's really going on? See where the lineage issues are. See, you will see things with fresh eyes. If you are seeing everything clearly with new eyes, you see it clearly with your twin. This is your clarity, okay? Now, the full moon is usually for exposing things. This is where your senses are heightened, you're seeing things, okay? You're doing the outward work. It's time for sometimes actions or Thanksgiving, maybe non-actions, maybe you don't eat as much, maybe you don't drink, maybe you know when to say when and you say, I have to go now. Maybe if you're sitting there and the atmosphere gets too thick, you have to leave. The minute someone starts on their political, religious soapbox and it's uncomfortable for you, get out. The minute people start picking on you, picking on the children, go out for a walk. Or decide that, you know what? You can very graciously be thankful and say, thank you. It was so enjoyable. I have to go now. And some of you have trouble with that. It's hard for you to actually say to people, I have to go. Some of you, if you've been taught like I have from a child, you stay and help the hostess. You help set up, you help clean up, you do the dishes. Well, guess what? Not everyone wants you there. Sometimes they want their own space. So feel what you feel about it. This is your own true love story. If you're having a struggle with Thanksgiving and it sends you up into the mental body, what are you sending over to your twin flame's head if they're away from you? Now, if you're with your twin flame, I hope that you absolutely enjoy yourself. Have fun. And again, know what the limits are in terms of, you know, how are you celebrating it? Only you will know what you can eat, what you can do, what you can handle. So some of the things to be thankful for. These will be people that have come into your life, people that have helped you. This may be an opportunity to mend a fence with someone, mend a quarrel. If you cannot speak it out loud, you speak it inside you. And I had some reminders of being grateful. We had a snowstorm here in Chicago on Saturday, and we didn't really expect it. It usually doesn't come this early, but winter came early, and my guidance was winter is coming. I got that guidance of several months ago when the weather was gorgeous, and it came to me and it said winter is coming, sort of jokingly, but there it was, winter is coming. And I got the roof leak fixed. I, you know, did what I could to winterize the house, cleaned up the leaves, etc. But I had a cat. Oddly, the storm was named Winter Storm Bella. And I had a cat once. There's the cat. The cat's name was Bella. And this cat helped me heal my cat allergy that I had as a child. I would become asthmatic if I were near cats. And with the asthma and the healing that I did, because it was very much an inside job, I realized that I was actually healing my relationship with cats using the love of my union. But the storm, the name of the storm, it was a storm. I had a shovel, I had to do everything. But there was my kitty, who's been deceased now for several years. He actually needed to exit. Always an indoor kitty, and he started going out of the house. I knew something was up, and I would tune in, and all I would get was, I need to go, I need to go, I need to go, I need to go where? And sometimes you have to help a friend along, and I did help my friend along. But the person who I am, I needed to have a going away party for my friend, my good friend who had helped me. And I did. I had a going away party, and I put out a plate of chicken breast, and the morning I went to take him to the vet, he was up on my piano, and a butterfly came right up to his nose, separated by a piece of glass. There was a window there. He was right at the window, and here was a butterfly, and I just, that touched me so deeply. And when I got to the vet, there was another cat there, a sort of a greeter cat. And I just felt that this cat was there to help assist. And it talked to me like cats do. Meow, 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 meow. Didn't understand a word really, but the feel that I got was, I'm here to help. You can let go. I will help your lovely Bella transition over. And there are transitions. There are people still leaving. There are world events. There are accidents. And it's always about how do we stay balanced? How do we get through our mourning process? My cat didn't need a going away party. I needed the going away party. My cat could have cared less about a going away party and everyone coming to light a candle for the cat. And my family knew me. I've always been somewhat the, you know, the one in the family who's a little bit wild. That's me. But they have known me throughout the years that my heart's huge. I mean, there is nothing that will actually stop me from doing some of this stuff when it comes to that. So they showed up, and even if they thought I was kooky, I didn't care. I just didn't care. I knew I was doing it my way. That was a bit egoic on my part. But that helped me with my mourning process in being able to say goodbye to my friend properly and give a proper send-off. We don't always get that opportunity. Many times we're doing it after the fact, giving people a proper send-off. Be good to the people you care about. Be good. I also got some cards to mail. This one's actually going to my insurance agent, who did a little special favor for me. Just a thank you. And you might think, a lot of people think, well, I'm paying them. That's enough thank you. No, it's not. Be willing to reach out. This is going to a relative who lives far away. And, you know, it's you doing little things that make a significant difference in someone's life. If you can't do it for your twin, do some things for someone else. But what you do for your twin is enjoy, be calm, be stable, take yourself out of a situation when you can. You have to know when to fly away. You're the only one who can. Many of us, when we show up with our family for a holiday, we turn into little kids again. We get bossed around. We get told the dynamic in the house is exactly the same. The atmosphere hasn't changed. Maybe Uncle so-and-so is drinking. Or we see someone who was a significant abuser. And it's very difficult to be up against that. It is. A lot of people have situations where the abuse was so terrible that they've blanked a lot of it. And it'll come up at odd times like this. And how do you get it gone? Well, the very first thing is knowing when to say when and getting yourself out of it. You're not here to live in a low vibration anymore. The minute it starts to get low, move. Get your butt moving. That's what you do. And it's okay. If you are hosting, take a break. Mini breaks will make a big difference for you. Taking a break doesn't mean whining with a glass of wine or seven glasses of wine. I'm not saying you can't drink wine, but some of you know you can't drink the wine. I'm one of them. I gave that up a long time ago, but everyone's doing that at their own speed. Clarity is seeing the significant changes or feeling it. Of what do you want to change? What is it that you feel needs to change? All right? So let's talk about delving back into karmic situations. When you delve back in with someone who is some kind of karmic person to you, they may be living in karma even if you're not. You're going to be the one that feels it, and they won't. Many times they will not. It could be your children, it could be siblings, it could be a friend. And if you find yourself doing some of the same behaviors, maybe you hide things, maybe you're sneaky, you get defensive, you want to fight them, you wish you could hit them. Again, it's catching those things. That is the first part of it. Catch it, because it's low 3D and this is where it's going to be at. You came here for the love. You came here to be in love again. Your twin flame came here to be in love. Let them feel you. Let them, for this full moon, feel the expansiveness of your love for them. Let them feel what it's like, what they have been missing for some, in many cases, lifetimes. Many, many cases, it's been lifetimes that they have not been able to feel properly. They are thinking this is as good as it gets. Especially if they're a man, and I am not here to knock men. What I am saying is that men have their little bag of skills and tool sets and defenses that they use. When it's your twin, there is complete transparency. You'll see right through each other, but the seeing through each other, does, rather than being vulnerable, it's being safe. Let your twin feel safe with you. That's what you want. This is kind of a significant hurdle this week for a lot of people, because what happens here is preparing so many of you for the solstice in December. If you don't know, the very one thing you need to do is hold steady. You know what you know. I'm going to say it. You know you're not crazy. You know that you're feeling things multidimensionally. You know that your senses are heightened. The people around you have heightened senses too. They may not have as many answers as you have, but that doesn't mean that they're morons. They will know. I would like to encourage everyone. You're not here for the intelligence quotient. You're here for your emotional quotient. You're expanding. You're not just feeling sadness. Well, I felt sad. Some people can't even express it. I think I felt sad. They don't even catch it when they feel a feeling. They try to shove it back down. There is no shoving it back down. It's coming out of our guts. It's been vomited up from the high level, the upper GI and all the parts up here, and the lower level, all of the lower GI and everything. You're getting it out from everywhere. And people that, you know, won't be able to stay hidden anymore. You can't hide it. You can't hide the corruptions. You can't hide people behind barbed wire. You can't hide children. You cannot hide a spouse. You cannot hide some of the things anymore. You're going to know it. You're going to know what your twin flame's fears are. If you're not getting other people out of your space and knowing when to cut off, or temporarily cut off, you can't feel your twin. You're the only one who can feel and pull them. It's your magnetic heart. And I'm going to repeat this so that you're clear. This is your cosmic, sacred, shared heart. Not someone else's. Not a spouse. Not your ex. Not the person in the film, not someone on the TV, unless it's really your twin. It's your sacred heart. And it's there. And that's your eternal connection. And nobody can cut it. And nobody should cut it. Many times I find out from people that they will have had some type of either reading or someone who tells them some information. And I do hear more and more that people are only able to read the mental body. So if you're getting answers that are telling you things like, he or she doesn't want to be with you in this lifetime, that is really not the reason you were born. You weren't just born to just, you know, let go. Why come into this dimension to let go? You're in this dimension for a reason. You become aware of each other for a reason. Many people are forgetting their own awakenings. You're forgetting your heart. The part of you that awakens and enlivens is your heart. Whether you call it heart chakra, Kundalini rising, whether it blasts open or it's been a gradual enlightening process. What do you do when you're enlightened? You maintain it. Okay, you've achieved enlightenment. There's still more to go. There are levels and levels and levels. There are levels that are not here at this physical dimension. You have an entirely brand new fresh start here and new love making. There's no telling what your love will create with each other. So I want to swing this back around, because this is you and your twin flame. There's you, and whether or not you're with them, whether they're across the miles, whether you're celebrating a Thanksgiving and they're not, what do you want them to feel from you across the miles? What do you want them to feel right next to you? What do you want your twin flame? Do you want them to get all of the mental scatter and the ping pong and the stress? Take time with yourself. This is a stressful week. There's weather, there's travel, there's family, there's children, there's baggage, there's karma. Do yourself a favor and refresh. Refresh, refocus. If you don't get focused, and if you don't feel, okay, get yourself some tools. There are things to do so that you can be. There are ways to feel the love again. I have feedback from people that my tools work. I want to tell you this. You have a heart, and you're the only one with this eternal connection. Don't squander these times. This may be tough times. There may be many things that distract you or your twin flame. I really want to encourage you now. Please stay focused. The love is here, and the love is always going to be how you feel each other. So, thank you so much for listening. Thank you for watching my videos. Thank you for buying my webinar. Yes, I will say it because there's usually one person that asks, yes, I do readings. Yes, I do sessions. They're scheduled. People are in different time zones. I do my best to get to everyone's request, but you can order it through my website, which is www.twinflamesmerge.com. And I wish everyone a happy Thanksgiving. And even if you're not celebrating, please know that here in the United States, what the heart focus is gratitude, abundance, being grateful for abundance, being willing to share, being willing to give, being willing to be open, being willing to fix things. Repair things, being willing to love things back into wholeness. And yes, there's a lot of that that's still going to take place. It's homegrown. It starts on the inside. This is homemade work, just like my homemade videos. And thank you so much. I really do appreciate all of you who've stayed here on the journey. We need you. Your twin needs you. We're going to get there. And this winter solstice, the summer solstice in the southern hemisphere, it is very significant. So please do your part. That's all that's ever asked of you. Just do what you do best, just for today. Thank you very much. Have a wonderful week. Have a wonderful day. Go out and view the full moon and really feel. Bye now.